Hi everybody, welcome to my channel. In this video I'm going to show how to use SQLite. SQLite is a database engine. So the difference is we don't need any SQL server in order to run the database. It's just a small database we can embed in our programs. That is really useful for Android development, for example, or Python, but we can use this database in another programs as well. No, this is a small DB file. We can embed in any kind of program. So it's especially useful when we have a small traffic in the database and just a few tables, just a few operations. So it's not working well if we have big programs or if we have several users interacting at the same time with the database, no? It's not like a SQL server or another big database management. Well, so I'm going to start now. So basically we need to download SQLite from the official website, sqlite.org. So we have SQLite for Android, Linux, Mac and Windows. So I'm going to download for Mac now. So as you can see, it's nothing, so it's like a 3 week. So basically we have the executable file here, SQLite. So we are able to create an environment and call this command for any part of the shell. But at the moment, so I don't have that, but I already have the folder here with the files. So the first step is create the database. So for create the database, it's really simple. So we need to type the command and the name of the database, SDB. And then if we want to see which database we have available, so it's .database, as you can see here. So that command create the new database in blank. So if we need more help, so as the shell suggests here, so use .help. So all the commands started with .. So and what I am going to do next is create the tables in the database. So I'm going to create a small table, just an example. It's the create table, like the SQL command. So we are able for use all the classic SQL command here. So I'm going to create a student table. So the classical the example. So we have a graphic interface as well. I'm going to show after. So but at the moment I'm going to show how to do that using the command line, no? So if you want to something fast, so you can use this command line. And so varchar, so as you can see, it's practically the same. And then the primary key, no? We need to define the primary key. Primary key is the ID. So this ID here. So finish with semicolon, and then if we wanted to visualize the table, it's .table, And as you can see here, so the table was created. So remember when I enter here, so I enter in this database. So if we already create this database, so we need to use dot open and the name of the database. So what I'm going to do next is insert values in this new table. So it's the same SQL a sentence here, students, and then so it's values. I need to insert the name, the surname, and students, the subject, well, so I always forgot the semicolon at the end, but if you forgot something or the comma is wrong, so we have another line here. So I'm going to insert another value here. Again, I forgot the semicolon. Yeah, so the last one, because you see we have too many now. Okay, so next step is we need to use select, but it's a classic select, and then the table. And as we can see here, so in this table we created all the records, no? So the format is not really nice, so we are able to change this format and use the classic formats. So that is a mode and then columns. And now if I type select, we have the in columns the all the rows separated by columns, no? So we don't have a header here, but we can add the header as well. So if we wanted to know which column is, so that is headers on. Headers on. And as you can see here, we have the IDs and all the column name, no? So we have an update as well. Update, so it's the same a sentence. So they set So I'm going to change these two rows here. And as you can see here, that changed the first name, no? Well, so another classic SQL command is delete. Students were as you can see here, it's working. So the four classic SQL operations we have, and well, so that is the basics on how to use this SQL SQLite. And I'm going to show next how to install the graphic interface, because it's not really convenient for the majority of the people use the command line for create the tables and the new values. So basically we have this SQL SQLite browser that is it's not official from the SQLite, but it's another website. So I'm going to download from Mac. So I already have the program in my system, so I don't need to install it again. This one. So well, in here it's really easy, no? To create and to open the database, so we don't need to remember any command. So basically I'm going to open my database. So as you can see here, we have the table students and we have the four columns. And if we wanted to know the content of this, so we have the content here, so we are able to change easily the values and create a new rows easily here, no? So we don't need to remember any command. Well, that's everything for this video. Thank you very much for watching, and see you in the next one. Ciao.